I did here today is actually I had a photo shoot with Per Bernal, and actually was it was for my wife. We're having a baby in June, and my wife wanted to show how, like, you know, fit for pregnancy obviously works, and she looks really good, gained only 26 pounds, so that's not that much. But everything is healthy, I'm very excited about that, and she feels good and hip, and so in 4 weeks, I hope I see how he looks.
Hey, Kim, I'm standing here and he's filming.
My wife is Kim Lyons, and a lot of people know her from The Biggest Loser. She was a red team trainer on seasons 3 and 4. And obviously she used to be a competitive fitness girl, and that's how we met. After a couple of years, it kind of started blinking and blowing, and then things kind of blow up, and here we are, so married today. I come to my comeback and to weightlifting, back into bodybuilding. 3-4 years ago, I decided I need to kind of step away a little bit and find my why. And I had plans to get married and wanted to have children and things like that. So, and I thought I need to focus on something else. And I always wanted to do acting. And I thought, oh, maybe I take some serious acting classes. What I did, actually, with two different teachers. And you know, I always went still to the Olympia, and I wanted to see, you know, if I still have the it, like, does it still itch? And it always itched. And I said, you know what, I think I will try to do a couple more shows. And, you know, I still feel like I have it, I got it. And, you know, my wife Kim is supportive of it. And I said, you know, why not? So it's always good to be, you know, where your heart is. And I follow my heart right now.
I think it's great for the sport to have Gunter back in the sport, and you know, we had some good battles back in the day, and of course he took off to do his film stuff, and of course now he's back trying to make a comeback. And you know, Gunter's a bodybuilder at heart. He came to the United States from Germany to be a bodybuilder. I mean, that's why he came here, so I can understand why he wants to come back and compete, and I'm sure he misses it, and I wish him the best. I see him in here a lot, so. He's a very good guy, and we were good friends, you know, as we came up through the ranks. We came up kind of together, so.
Do I do anything different? Yes, I will. I don't want to go up in my, you know, off-season weight as heavy as I used to be, because I think I went at some point, I felt like I was too far. I was at 330, and I just feel, I didn't like the feel of it. It was like, I just felt heavy, sluggish and everything. A nutritionist, I haven't really made up my mind. So I know a lot about nutrition myself, but sometimes you know how that is. If you have to do it yourself, it can get very confusing at some point. And sometimes it's good if somebody really tells you what to do, especially as an athlete. It's how MD helps the sport. I believe they do an awesome job on how the athlete is represented, and how the athlete looks to the outside of the sport. When you read an article, it's not just, hey, here's another bodybuilder, look how he trains. No, it's about, hey, here's another bodybuilder, look, you know, who that is. And that's what I like about it.
What do you think, man?
Cool, love it. He has a good eye,
he's the best. He does a good job. Yeah. I think the level still of competition grows every year. I mean, it's really crazy. I mean, it seems like, first of all, I think a lot has to do really with nutritional companies over the years. The quality of the products, they got so much better. In the past, there were a lot of times you didn't have all these things they're already available today, you know, especially in like over-the-counter nutrition. And you can tell just by the level of how the Arnold's Classic is, and also last year's Olympia and stuff. So the competition is definitely growing, and it becomes tough and tough out there. Yeah. People always say when you hold that baby the first time and then it opens eyes, that first connection is just, you can't explain it. It's like the most memorable moment probably in your whole life. And for me right now, I mean, obviously I haven't had that yet, but I can tell how I think. Just today, I'm driving down here to the shoot and I look to the side, a preschool, and it was in Manhattan Beach. I looked at Kim and said, do you think that's a good preschool? I mean, who would think of that? The baby's not even there, not even born. But I always thought I kind of like kids. I love kids. Kids always come to me, and it seems like, you know, kids kind of like me. They always think I'm Mr. Incredible. Actually, that happened one time at the pool. A girl comes up to me, are you Mr. Incredible? You look like him. And I say, yes, I am. You know, she didn't know I wasn't, but, you know, she liked it. But now it will be exciting, and I'm looking forward to seeing it.